Hello, assalamu alaikum. I like to welcome you to today's top news reading from the front page of the Daily Star. Our today's news headline is Demo Roadblock Distract City Traffic. Traffic in the capital's northern part was brought to its knees throughout yesterday by a faction of the Tabligh Jamaat as it blocked the busy airport road first protesting the arrival of the religious group's top scholar from India to attend Vishwa Ijtema. Followers of the faction, mostly belonging to radical Islamist group Hefazati Islam, sat on the road and chanted slogans against Maulana Shad Khandalvi for what they claimed were his controversial comments about the Quran and Sunnah. Thousands of city dwellers, especially office goers, students and commuters, suffered badly as they remained stranded on the road for hours. Most of the domestic and international flights were delayed as captains, crew members and passengers all got stuck in the traffic jams, airlines officials said. Here is a scenario of the traffic stands still on airport road in the capital yesterday after members of Tabligh Jamaat men blocked the airport intersections. Okay, then people on their hundreds were seen walking for miles to reach their destinations. Many sufferers came down heavily on the government and the police for allowing the demonstration to occupy such a vital road for so many hours. The protest was organized by the Bangladesh Qaumi Madrasa Education Board and Hefazati Islam on instructions of Shah Ahmed Shafi, chief of Hefazat, and the Qaumi Madrasa Education Board demonstrators said. The demonstrators were mainly Qaumi Madrasa students and teachers who could not say exactly what Maulana Shad said to bring them to the streets. It began around 9 a.m. when the demonstrators took a position on the road in front of the airport. Soon the public on the busy thoroughfare extended up to Banani in the south and Tongi in the north as more of their men joined the protest. A large group of them blocked the entrance to the VIP terminal, hearing the Shad arrived at the airport around 11 p.m. They were seen checking vehicles in efforts to prevent Shad's departure from the airport. In the process, most of those who came from abroad suffered. Rehana is one of the... She landed from Dubai at 11:30 p.m. but was stranded inside for over 3 hours. Here is another picture of parents carry two sick children to a hospital after being stuck in the jam for almost 4 hours. Okay, then her husband hired a car to go to their village home in Faridpur, but he had to abandon the car as it did not move in more than half an hour. Later, the couple was seen waiting with several luggage on the footpath near the airport roundabout. Aminur Islam and 5 other youths from Nauga arrived at Mohakali bus terminal around 9 a.m. to catch a flight to Saudi Arabia. Sensing trouble on the road, they started for the airport around 1:15 p.m., although their flight was to depart at 11 p.m. After coming to Banani, our bus got stuck. We had to walk the whole way, Aminu told the Daily Star at 4:30 p.m. near the airport. After spending several hours on the road, Arifa Manzoor picked up her two kids from the Aga Khan School in Uttara around 3 p.m. at 9 p.m. In p.m., she was still on way to her Gulshan home. Here is another picture for you. Okay, then Biman Bangladesh Airlines General Manager Public Relations Shakil Miraj said almost all domestic and international flights is scheduled to fly between 10 a.m. to 8 p.m. were affected. The flight were delayed for 30 minutes to 1 hour, he told the Daily Star last night. On average, 130 international and domestic flights, both outgoing and inbound, operate through the Hazrat Shahjalal International Airport, Daily sources said. At 9:50 p.m., Shahriar, who works in Farmgate, wrote on his Facebook, "Already 5 hours since I left office. I still don't know when I would reach home." Vehicles started moving after the agitators left the road at 4:30 p.m., but the congestion that spilled over to different roads remained till 10 p.m. Before leaving the street, Mufti Mahfuzul Haq, principal of Jamia Rahmania Qaumi Madrasa in the city's Muhammadpur, said they would block the Kakrail Mosque so that Maulana Sad, who was staying at the mosque, could not come out. Kakrail Mosque is considered the headquarter of the Bangladesh chapter of Tabligh Jamaat. "We told the government to send him back to India. We will allow Maulana Shah to come out to the mosque only if he wants to go back," said Mahfuzul, Joint Secretary General of Hifazat Ran Qaumi Madrasa Education Board. Maulana Afshar Ali, Vice President of the same Education Board and the second man in Hifazat after Maulana Shafi, and Maulana Abdul Quddus, Secretary General of the Board, were among other top leaders present during the protest. Speaking at the protest, Quddus said they spoke with the Home Minister to the Maulana Shad so that Maulana Shad can enter the country, and yet he did. "He gave some wrong explanation of the Quran. He has to apologize for it. That only then will we receive him with open arms," he told the protest program. He, however, did not say what exactly Maulana Shah said to draw their ire. The Chief Mufti of Hazari Qaumi Madrasa, Mufti Kifayatullah, attended the protest as the representative of Shafi. After Mufti Mahfuzul's announcement of blocking Kakrail Mosque, authorities beefed up security around the mosque by deploying some 40 police personnel. Police were deployed to avert any untoward incidents due to the prevailing tension, said Maruf Hossein Sardar, Deputy Commissioner, Ramna Division of Dhaka Metropolitan Police, who was at the Kakrail Mosque at 10:45 p.m. Police are seen allowing people to enter the mosque only after verification. The Daily Star tried to contact Syed Asif Islam, a key leader of Tabligh Jamaat, but he did not pick up the phone. Authorities in the Kakrail Mosque would not make any comment either. The Istima begins on Saturday on the bank of Turki Turak River in Tongi. A rift in the Bangladesh chapter's public leadership surfaced after the Hifazat-backed section raised voice against some of Shah's statements and demanded cancellation of his Bangladesh visit last year. His statements caused uproar on several occasions and division in the leadership of the Nizamuddin Markaz of Delhi, considered the international headquarters of Tabligh Jamaat. The anti-Shahid group took a tough stance against his joining this year's Ijtema, and the 11-member Shura Council got divided over the issue. They sat for several meetings with the Home Minister to resolve the issue.